Now next example is of copper sulfate solution. Here we have taken copper sulfate solution. It means aqueous copper sulfate dissolved in water. Now when you will pass electricity, then copper sulfate will dissociate into copper ions and sulfate ions, right? Now remember, here we have used copper electrodes. It means active electrodes are used here, right? Water, because we have taken an aqueous solution, so water is also present here. That will also dissociate into hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion. Now positive ions, copper ion and hydrogen ion, these two ions will move towards cathode. But out of these two, only copper ion will discharge, because copper ion has lower position in the reactivity series. So here copper ions will get reduced to form copper atom. So reddish brown metal will get deposit at cathode. Now at anode, these two ions will move at anode, negatively charged ion, sulfate ion and OH ion. But none of the ion will get discharged here, because it is the active electrode that is made up of copper. It itself will lose electron to form copper ions. Okay? It itself will lose electrons to form copper ions, and these copper ions from anode, it will lose copper ions, and these copper ions will mix here in the copper sulfate solution. Now some important questions that can be asked here. Suppose we have used inactive electrodes here, then this reaction at cathode will be same, but at anode yahan par kya hoga, instead of sulfate ions, OH ions will release, that will form oxygen here. So oxygen will form at anode. If we use inert electrodes here, then oxygen will be formed here. Okay, now the question comes in your exam that when we do electrolysis of copper sulfate solution using inactive electrodes, inert electrodes, then the color of copper solution fades after some time. But if you use active electrodes, then color of copper sulfate doesn't fades, it remains blue only. Ye question exam mein bahut aata hai. This is very important. Reason is ki when you use inert electrodes, when you use